गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आवर चैप्टर नंबर 11 ऑफ सेकंड फिजिक्स इज गोइंग ऑन विच इज रे ऑप्टिक्स. ओके, टुडे वी लर्न ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक विच इज टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. सो आवर टुडे टॉपिक इज टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. We know that when, suppose this is a surface, okay, and this is normal on this surface. When a light ray, this is light ray incident on this surface, this is incident ray, then some part of this light ray is reflected and remaining part of this light ray is refracted in a other medium like this. This is a reflected ray and this is reflected ray. Okay, and we know that when the light ray goes from and we know that when the ray of light goes from denser to rare medium, suppose this is a surface and this is a denser medium, this is a rarer medium. Okay, when the ray of light, this is normal ray of light, goes from denser to, this is angle I, denser to rarer medium, then in this situation the ray, reflected ray, bends away from the normal, means in this direction. In this way, angle R is greater than angle I. It means reflected angle is greater than compared to incidence angle. Okay, now if we increase, if we increase in incidence angle, then in this situation angle of refraction also increases. Okay, and sorry, this is angle I. If increase in angle of incidence, then angle of reflected also increases. Okay, and a particular value of this incidence angle I, the angle of refraction becomes 90 degree. Angle of refraction becomes 90 degree. It means the refracted, this reflected ray goes along separating surface. Means this angle R is equals to 90. It means agar aap isko aur badhaye, then is condition mein जो रिफ्लेक्टेड एंगल है वो 90 डिग्री होगा. एंड वी कैन से द रिफ्लेक्टेड रे इज अलोंग टू द सेपरेटिंग सरफेस. नाउ वी इंक्रीज अगेन इन रिफ्लेक्ट इंसिडेंस एंगल, देन इन दिस सिचुएशन दिस इज एंड दिस एंगल्स इज कॉल्ड क्रिटिकल एंगल थीटा सी. इट मीन्स when the angle of incidence at this angle, the rays goes from denser to rare medium, then this angle is corresponding to this angle, reflecting angle is 90 degree, then this angle is critical angle, this incidence angle is a critical angle. Okay, and now we increase incidence angle from this critical angle, means इससे अगर अपन और ज्यादा इसमें increment करें, then is this in इस condition में, means यहां here I is greater than theta c, means incidence angle critical angle से और ज्यादा है, then in this situation this reflected ray back in same medium, this is refracted ray, and this phenomena is called total internal reflection. Okay, it means if light rays propagating from dense to rare medium and incident at an angle more than critical angle theta c, then rays are reflected back in a same direction, same medium. This phenomena is called total internal reflection. Okay, clear it? This is total reflection, internal reflection. In total internal reflection, there is no absorption of light and there is no transmission of a light. Here, total internal reflection is exist. Okay, students. Now, it means we can say in total internal reflection, intensity of a light remains same. Okay. Now, relation between theta c, critical angle, and refractive index of a medium means mu n. We know that Snell's law, mu 1 sin I is equals to mu 2 sin R. Here mu 1 is the refractive index of denser medium and mu 2 is the refractive index of a rare medium. Okay, and here we consider rare medium is air, so for air mu 2 approx equals to 1 and mu 1 is equals to suppose that mu m. Okay, and I is incidence angle, and suppose incidence angle is theta c, means critical angle, then in this situation at a critical angle R becomes 90 degree. So mu m into sine theta c is equals to 1 into sine 90, and we know that value of sine 90 is equals to 1, so mu m is equals to 1 upon sine theta c. This is the relation between refractive index of medium and a critical angle of a medium. Okay, this is very useful for our numerical questions, so carefully learn this relation. Now we take some examples. Suppose water. For water, refractive index mu is equals to 1.33 and critical angle theta c is equals to 48.75 degree. Okay, next suppose diamond. Okay, diamond mu is equals to 2.42 and theta c is equals to 24.41 degree. Here we can easily see that the refractive index of diamond is greater than compared to water. Okay, and this is greater than compared to glass, because of a refractive index of glass is 1.52. okay, so these are the some examples. Now some incidents of a total internal reflection, or some uses of total internal reflection. So first is a mirages. What is mirages? Generally in desert, the observer observes the water at large distance and inverted image of trees are observed. This is due to total internal reflection. Okay, and this images this effect is called mirages. Okay, means in desert, suppose this is surface of earth. Okay, and in desert, temperature of the atmosphere at near to this earth is very high. Then in this situation, the density of this layer is less, so this is as a rare medium, and this above surface behaves as a denser medium. Okay, this is as a denser medium. This is denser medium. Okay, suppose यहां पर एक आपके पास tree है. This is a tree. और यहां observer है. जब लाइट रेज यहां से इंसिडेंट होंगी, देन इस कंडीशन में यू कैन इजिली सी दैट दिस लाइट रे कम्स फ्रॉम डेंसर टू रेयर मीडियम एट ए फिक्स स्पेसिफिक एंगल. दिस एंगल इज ग्रेटर देन टू क्रिटिकल एंगल थीटा सी. देन इन दिस सिचुएशन दिस रे टोटली रिफ्लेक्टेड मीन्स एज लाइक टोटली रिफ्लेक्टेड. इस कंडीशन में इस ऑब्जर्वर को ऐसा फील होगा कि ये जो रे है, ये लाइट रे, ये यहां से आ रही है, कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस वे. एंड इन दिस सिचुएशन ए इमेज इज सीन बाय दिस ऑब्जर्वर. मींस इस कंडीशन में इस ऑब्जर्वर द्वारा यहां पे एक इस ट्री की इमेज देखी जाएगी. और इमेज कहां दिखती है अपने को? इमेज वाटर में दिखती है. कहां पे दिखती है? वाटर में. मींस इस ऑब्जर्वर को ऐसा फील होगा वर्चुअली कि यहां पे क्या है? वाटर. और इसी इफेक्ट को, इसी को अपन क्या कहते हैं? मिराज. एंड दिस इफेक्ट इज कॉल्ड मिराज. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज स्पार्कलिंग ऑफ डायमंड. स्पार्कलिंग ऑफ डायमंड. हेयर द एंड फेसेस ऑफ डायमंड, सपोज दिस इज ए डायमंड, देन एंड फेसेस ऑफ दिस डायमंड आर कट इन सच ए वे द लाइट रे वेन एवर स्ट्राइक ऑन इट देन द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस बिकम ग्रेटर देन थीटा सी मीन्स ग्रेटर देन क्रिटिकल एंगल. देन इन दिस सिचुएशन हेयर टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन टेक प्लेस अगेन एंड अगेन. मीन्स इसकी जो साइड्स हैं वो इस प्रकार से कट होंगी. देन उस कंडीशन में अगर कोई लाइट रे इसमें इंसिडेंट हो इंटर करेगी, देन ये जब इससे रिफ्लेक्ट होगी या फिर इस पे इंसिडेंस होगी, इंसिडेंट होगी, दिस इन कंडीशन में जो एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस है वो एंगल ग्रेटर देन ग्रेटर देन टू थीटा सी मीन्स क्रिटिकल एंगल होगा. देन इन दिस सिचुएशन एवरी साइड से इसी टाइप से यहां पे टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन होगा. देन इन दिस सिचुएशन द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ ए इंसिडेंस रे इंसिडेंट रे रिमेन्स सेम. ओके, एंड इन दिस सिचुएशन द डायमंड अपीयर्स स्पार्कलिंग लाइक दिस. दिस रे बिकम्स इन फॉलो दिस पाथ, देन दिस डायमंड अपीयर्स स्पार्कलिंग. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज थर्ड ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स. ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स. व्हाट इज ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स? जो अपने पास विजुअल और ऑडियो सिग्नल्स हैं उनको विदाउट एनर्जी लॉस अगर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस तक अपने को ट्रांसमिट करना है, देन अपन किसका यूज करेंगे? ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स का. मीन्स ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स में क्या होगा? टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. दिस ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स मेड बाय ए कोर, सिलेंड्रिकल कोर, एंड दिस कोर मेड बाय हाई क्वालिटी क्वार्ट्ज और ए ग्लास. ओके, इट मीन्स दिस इज लाइक बिहेव्स लाइक एज ए डेंसर मीडियम. ओके, एंड आउटर सिलेंडर, आउटर सिलेंडर कॉल्ड क्लेडिंग, एंड दिस क्लेडिंग मेड बाय सॉफ्ट सब्सटेंस. सो दिस क्लेडिंग बिहेव्स लाइक एज ए रेयरर मीडियम. दिस इज ए क्लेडिंग. नाउ इफ वी इंसिडेंस दिस इंसिडेंट दिस रे इन दिस कोर at a specific angle and this incidence angle greater than equals greater than to critical angle theta c, then here total internal reflection exists. So there is no loss of light energy in total internal reflection. So that this is outer ray and this is incident ray, then the outcoming ray is same intensity as that incident ray. Okay, so the light easily travels through along the fiber even if the fiber is bent. Okay students, this is the optical fiber. This is very useful for फॉर ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ ऑडियो एंड वीडियो सिग्नल्स विदाउट एनी एनर्जी लॉस फॉर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंसेस. ओके, दिस इज वेरी यूजफुल. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज रिफ्रैक्शन एट स्फेरिकल सरफेस. दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड दिस इज यूज इन ए लेंस. सो नेक्स्ट इज रिफ्रैक्शन एट रिफ्रैक्शन एट स्फेरिकल सरफेस. For this derivation, suppose we have a spherical surface. This is a spherical surface and this is principal axis. This is spherical surface A, B and this is pole P. Okay, now we consider a object, point object is placed at this point O. And suppose this is rare medium, so refractive index of this medium is mu 1 and this is denser medium and refractive index of this medium is mu 2. Now we consider object at this point O, then its object's two rays emit hongi, one is perpendicularly along to the normal and another one is this at this point, and this is the normal at this point which is passing through the center of curvature C. Okay, so this angle is I. This ray goes from rare to denser medium, then this ray bends towards to the normal, and in this situation the refracted rays are meet at this point I, and at this point I image we obtain a image. Okay, so I is the image of object O. Suppose this is angle alpha, and this angle is gamma, and this angle is beta, and this is refracted angle R. Okay, so this is beta. Sorry, this is beta, and this is gamma. This point, suppose this is point D. यहाँ पे कंसिडर करें कि पॉइंट डी इज वेरी क्लोज टू पॉइंट पी मीन्स पोल. इन दिस सिचुएशन एंगल एल्फा बीटा एंड गामा इज वेरी स्मॉल. ओके, नाउ इन दिस कंडीशन व्हेन पॉइंट डी इज पैलेस वेरी नियर टू द पोल, देन वी कंसिडर दिस डी पी इज ए स्ट्रेट लाइन. So in this situation, from triangle ODP, tan alpha. What is tan? Tan is the perpendicular upon base. Here perpendicular is DP upon base OP. So DP upon OP. Okay, and from triangle CPD, tan beta. Again, tan is equals to perpendicular, means DP upon base PC, and in triangle IPD, tan gamma is equals to perpendicular upon base, perpendicular DP upon base PI. Okay, here we consider alpha beta gamma is very small, that is the point D is very near to pole P. Then in this situation we know that if theta is very small, then sin theta and tan theta approx equals to theta and cos theta approx equals to 1. Then in this situation tan alpha approx equals to alpha, tan beta approx equals to beta, and tan gamma approx equals to gamma. So alpha is equals to DP upon OP, beta is equals to DP upon PC, and gamma is equals to DP upon PI. Okay, now from triangle ODC, this is ODC, and in this triangle this is outer angle I. This is outer angle I. This is exterior or outer angle, and we know that the exterior angle is equal to the sum of the opposite interior angles. Means here in triangle ODC, angle I is equals to angle alpha plus angle beta. Okay, so put the value of alpha and beta. So I is equals to DP upon OP plus DP upon PC. This is equation number one. And in other triangle D, this DIC, here exterior angle is beta and interior angle is R and gamma. Then beta is equals to R plus gamma, and we get R is equals to beta minus gamma. Put the value of beta and gamma in this equation, then R is equals to DP upon PC minus DP upon PI. This is equation number 2. Now from Snell's law, mu 1 sin I is equals to mu 2 sin R. Here again we consider I and R is very small, then in this situation sin I approx equals to I and sin R approx equals to R. So mu 1 I is equals to mu 2 R. Put the value of I and R from equation 1 and 2. Okay, then we get mu 1 into DP upon OP plus DP upon PC. Okay, is equals to mu 2 into DP upon PC minus DP upon PI. Here DP take common and cancel out to each in LHS and RHS, and multiplying mu 1 in the bracket, then we get mu 1 upon OP plus mu 1 upon PC is equals to mu 2 upon PC minus mu 2 upon PI. Now we take LCM, now we transferring, rearrange this equation, then mu 1 upon OP minus mu 2 upon plus mu 2 upon PI is equals to mu 2 upon PC minus mu 1 upon PC. Now take LCM PC, then mu 1 upon OP plus mu 2 upon PI is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon PC. Okay, now we write value of OP, PI and PC from this diagram with sign convention. Okay, so OP is the distance of object from pole, and this distance measured from this pole in this direction and incident direction of incident ray in this direction, means the direction of a length of a object, length of distance is opposite to the incidence ray, then we take OP as a negative. So OP is equals to minus U. Okay, next is PI. This is PIP is the distance of object from the pole, and this is in the direction of incidence ray. So this take as a positive. So this plus V, and next is PC. PC is the center radius of curvature, and this is also positive. So plus R. Put these values in this equation, then mu 1 upon minus U plus mu 2 upon plus V is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon R. Rearrange this equation, then mu 2 upon V minus mu 1 upon U is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon R. This is the equation for reflection for the spherical surface, and this equation is true for all type of spherical surfaces. Okay students, so our mirror part of this chapter has been completed. Okay, in next class we start a new topic, which is lens. Okay, so carefully learn it and remember it and write the all notes. Okay, and if you like this video, then like it and maximally share it and subscribe the channel, our channel. Okay, thank you.